going to talk about a subject which is called Do What You Can. And the blog is on page 111 in our book, A Touch of Peace. So Do What You Can, the idea came to me as a flash, as an insight in meditation. You know, I was having a meditation that was restless. Now, I don't know if that ever occurs to you, but many of us struggle with restlessness in our meditation, the mind going here and there. And in this particular case, I was struggling to try to bring my mind back and keep it focused. And I would get it focused for a little while and then it would drift off again. It was just, frankly, quite a restless meditation. And I was getting a little bit frustrated about the inability to focus. And then this insight came, this flash came. Why worry about those things that you cannot control? Do what you can. And so in that meditation, instead of being frustrated because my mind was restless, I thought, what can I do? Thinking about what can I do shifted the whole thing. So I immediately said, well, if I can't keep my mind from moving around, let me start with my body. Let me check my posture, my meditation posture. Let me make sure that for the next 5 minutes, I don't fidget, I don't adjust, I don't move my hands or my arms, I don't do anything that is going to introduce restlessness on the physical level. And then I also looked and I said, well, what else can I control? If I can't control my mind, I can control my body, yes, but is there anything else that I can do? I'm looking now for things that I can do, not being frustrated about what I can't do. And I realized that I could control my breath. I was doing some pranayama techniques, a practice of Kriya Yoga, but my mind was still wandering. So I said, well, if my mind is wandering with a longer technique, let me do a shorter technique. That I can do, and I can hold my mind steady. I can pay attention to a single regular breath. So I inhaled to a count of eight, held eight, and exhaled to a count of eight. I could hold my mind on that. And then I did a little bit longer, 12, 12, and 12. Then I said, can I hold this, not just for one round, but let me try to hold it for 12. That's a segment on a mala that we use. And so making an effort to hold my mind on the breath, feeling the breath, concentrating on it, letting it flow, watching the rhythm, all of those things, I was able to hold that steady for at least 12, and then I went on for more than that. Well, that shift of not looking at what I can't do and being frustrated about it, but looking at what I can do and doing that, allowed that meditation then to proceed after I started with that way. Then I went back, and now my mind was much calmer and much steadier and much more focused. And I actually had a very good meditation. But this subject is not limited to meditation alone. There are many, many things in life that we can't control. In fact, almost everything in life, let's face it, we can't control. But there are things that we can do. We can control when we go to bed. We can control when we get up. We can control outer things like what kind of books we read or what kind of videos or media we might watch. So the idea is, don't worry about the big things. Control what you can. And if you start there controlling what you can, you'll find that there is a lot that you can control, and it brings the uncontrollable, one might say, mass into a lot more order for us. So do what you can. God bless you.